left off and the clock has started. You've got speed. Welcome back to the Salty Dog server. I hope you like my face because you get to see it up close and personal. Something I noticed when I was getting ready to film the intro for this. But anyway, we are back on the Salty Dog server and it is nighttime. And as I talked about last episode, I want to stop living off of melon and zombie flesh. And I'm going to start by growing some wheat. Exciting things. Look at it grow. So exciting. Top quality content here. Not all I'm going to do. This is just going to be food to get me to town. That's right, we're going back to town today. We got some things to explore there. Hey. Back off. Stay back. Jerk. We have some things to explore there. It seems that Lee, FirstGenGamer, has left some Easter eggs around town. And figured I'd go check that out, along with trying to find some sources of other food, and just kind of exploring. And was this me? Oh yeah, that was me. Okay. And also possibly trying to take on the first dungeon now that the second dungeon is nearing completion. I think it might be time to tackle the first dungeon, even though we're overwhelmingly unprepared for it. Oh, hello. That's what I was saying. Let's put on our armor. Had it off there for the intro. I'm over here. Leave me alone. Yeah. Alright, let's go back to the crafting bench. We're going to need to make this bread to make our journey. And the also added benefit is I will try to keep you with me, and that will maybe give Sebbi some more information to find my base. I may cut it up a bit to make it a little bit difficult for him. I feel like I kind of want to make it a challenge. I don't want to give him a direct path. Make him kind of guess for it. So, without further ado, let's eat something because we're gonna die! Alright, let's go this way. That way is death. I don't like death. And, Sebbi mentioned in his latest video that he saw Mesa in the background, or he thinks he saw Mesa in the background. He did indeed see a Mesa. As you can see, there is a Mesa over here. In this general direction, next to the dark oak. Ow. I can do without being shot in the back. Let's move a little bit faster to get away from him and then slow back down. So yes, we are in a mesa. We are not that close, or not as close as Sebbi thinks we are. We're actually a little bit a ways away. And I originally, when I was walking, I saw this extreme hills area and was liking the way it looks. Liking the way it looked, I guess I would be the proper tense. Words. Difficulty. streaming after a long day of work. And I'm not that good with words to begin with, so. And he's gone. I guess he couldn't wait for my answer. But this is a pretty nice area. I like this kind of overhang. And I was tempted, but I wasn't really inspired on what to build here. So I liked the landscape, but I just didn't know what I was going to do with it. So I kind of moved on and found that dark oak forest. And let them know what we're doing. And this should be a pretty good giveaway to Sebbi of where I'm at. And this is going to be another interesting thing, is I got to work my way back home. Well, I'm not so sure about Sebbi. Alright, let's... Heading to, there's the tower I saw that I really liked. And I was like, that was the only thing I was worried about building over here. I'm rather close to his tower and other buildings over here. And I was afraid that I might encroach on the area. And even if he's okay with it, I'm not sure I would be okay with it, because it would bother me if my build didn't match his style, which it won't, and if his is visible, so he might not mind it, but I don't like having mismatching themes so close together if I'm responsible. I don't know, it's a weird thing. I have to be the one that makes it in order for me not to like it, but... Alright, we're back. As you can see, it's nighttime now, and that was a longer phone call with my brother. But anyway, what I was gonna say before I answered the phone was that here we are at Sebbi's place, and we're gonna go to Spawn Town. My base is in that direction, Sebbi. There, now I have both my bases covered. I can either show him where I came, how I got here, or I can just give him the general direction and some tidbits of the journey. We'll see what I do. Anyway, we're gonna continue down this subway path. Man, the subway station's down deep. And we're gonna go to spawn. And this is the preferred way, since I don't want to use up too much food. So anyway, to continue conversation we had at the end of, or during the last video, we were talking cars and what I might do for my next one, and I mentioned what I wanted, and our good friend Paul mentioned how can I not have considered a Miata? And to be honest, I didn't consider the Miata, mostly because I don't like the way the new Miata looks. And that was actually solved, though, by the new Miata RF. Spawn Town, we want to go this way. The new RF, which is the hardtop convertible version of the Miata, is actually kind of nice. And I'm interested in... Ooh, my computer didn't like that spot. I'm interested in trying to maybe consider that as an option. I think that wouldn't be too terrible. You know it's going to be very reliable. It's not an ugly car, but it's not the prettiest. So I don't know. It's still up in the air, and we'll figure it out from there. One other thing I can talk about as I start to go for a little trip. One diamond per item. I don't know if I have... I don't have any diamonds, Sebbi. I'm sorry, I can't afford your... water. So another kind of vehicle related thing is I can talk about a project idea I've had, and was thinking about recently, which is that I would like to try to find a FC-150, Jeep FC-150, which is a, it's the shorter version of the forward control that I already own. And the reason I want to look at that is that I want to try to take one of those and make it into a good daily driver in just kind of whatever condition it's in. I don't want it to be fully restored, pristine condition. I want to turn it into a workable driver. So we are in here. Oh wait, what am I doing? We're in here. Doo-doo, Promi Powers. I got an Easter basket. Pretty. I like that. Take that back to our non-existent house. Guess we gotta use a pick for this. Yep. And this is, thank you for Lee for setting this up. This is our kind of mailbox system. So if you're on the server, you can just leave that for things for me if you don't want to find my base. All right. I think this is where the temple is, but let's walk around and try to find some Easter eggs. And we can talk about this Jeep idea I have. So the basic premise of what I'm thinking is I want to take the Jeep, and most of these Jeeps came with a flat four, or not the flat four, but the overhead cam four cylinder, which is in the 3Bs, the CJ 3Bs. It takes that engine and it uses that engine, and I would like to pull that out because I have no interest in using that for this idea. And what I would like to do is pull it and replace it with a 4.0 liter. And this is similar to actually a concept Jeep that Jeep did for the Easter Jeep Safari. It was a FC-150, however it was on a TJ, a Jeep TJ frame, which is like the 97 to 2003 or 2006. I'm not entirely sure the end date of the TJ Jeep. And I think the main reason they used that was they were able to kind of reuse some of the mounting, and also has the better suspension, had coilovers. That's one of the best, the main features of the TJ, which made it such a popular off-roader, is the fact that it has coils front and rear, makes it much more capable off-road. But I would like to put a 4.0 in the FC and kind of turn it into a nice daily driver, if it could be such a thing. I love FCs. I love that kind of Jeep, and I would like to be able to just kind of drive it daily without... Ooh, we found one. Boop. It's a head. I think that's an Easter egg, though. Looks like an Easter egg. But I'd like to be able to drive it daily if it rains, if it snows, and not worry about it. And I think if I change out the powertrain to be just like an automatic, a 4.0 with an automatic, I don't want to deal with an AX15, which is the manual transmission that is mated to the 4.0 liter. The reason I don't want to deal with that is because it's not designed for having a cab over. You would have to completely change the shift linkage, and I do not have the engineering prowess or backing that Jeep has, so they were able to do such things. Actually, no, they stuck with an automatic, so they didn't even bother with it. So even Jeep didn't bother engineering that much. So I certainly don't want to go through that trouble, because that's the way to turn a 2-year project into a 10-year project. And I want to try to avoid that at all costs. And I think that would be like a really cool thing to do, is just have a nice Jeep that drives around and just I can enjoy and not have to worry as much about rust and everything. Like the FC I have right now, I'm trying to use thoroughly to get enjoyment out. I don't want to just keep it in a garage and have it remain in pristine condition. I want to have fun. I want to enjoy it. And I'm doing my best to do that. But I would like to have something I could worry even less about. So that's kind of a build idea I've had and been thinking about and trying to determine how I could do it. And it probably financially wouldn't be too terrible. You can find a used 4.0 liter for under like $1,000. I also have a spare one just sitting around from a Jeep I bought and tore apart for $500. So I have a spare. I have one sitting around, so I have the means to make it. I never noticed that. That's a nice touch. Having the anvils in the item frames on the end there. But and then the FC itself, you're looking at maybe, depending on what kind of condition it is in, 3 to like maybe $7,000. So they're not terrible. It's definitely doable. And I think that'd be really cool. The only difficulty I'm going to have with that is I have to make the decision to not buy a different Jeep, which is a difficult decision for me, because there's so many I want to own and enjoy. Like, one of the other main ones I want to get is a Willy's Wagon. Is that? That's a crab. Don't break that. I should double check. This looks like an Easter egg. Let's give it a good once over. I'm going to say that's an Easter egg. But the Willy's Wagon is one I definitely want to get. And the Willy's truck, like a 40s to 50s Willy's truck, would be really neat. Another one that's not terrible to try to get and own. They're only somewhere between I shouldn't say that. Depending on condition, if you want to go really crummy condition, you can get it as low as $2,000. Oh, this is Ultimate AFK Farm. Interesting. I think he was telling me about that because he said there's a chicken farm there where I could get some free chicken, because I told him I was living off of melon and melon and zombie flesh. But the trucks range anywhere between $2,000 to $15,000 for a like pristine one. Ooh, here's another Easter egg. Ooh, piece of candy. So that's another one I want to own. I'm probably going to be looking to buy one in the $5,000 range, because I want one I can work on a little bit and then sell. I probably will lose a little money in it, but I just want to kind of buy it, own it for a little bit, fix some things up, drive it, and then sell it. I don't have too much of an attachment to that, but I'm sure that'll all change as soon as I own it. And then I'll say, well, I think I can keep this one. And then next thing I know, I'll have 7 Jeeps. But let's just not talk about that. We're going to pretend like that's not going to happen. I'm definitely going to sell it. There's no doubt in my mind I'm going to sell it. Maybe. Possibly. I don't have a problem, I swear. It's not an issue. I can quit whenever I want. It's surprising how much it is like an addiction. It pretty much is. It's an addiction that's not bad for my body. That's the thing. That's the only difference, really. It has pretty much all the means of an addiction. It's just not frowned upon by society, which is good. So I think we got two Easter eggs, and to be honest, I think I've been roaming around here for quite a while talking about Jeeps, as I as is going to be a very common theme, and I'm not going to be surprised if there's multiple episodes like this where I just kind of walk around talking, and I hope people can enjoy that. It's I guess you can kind of treat it like a podcast in that aspect if for these kind of episodes. But I think with that, unless I don't have enough footage, this will be the end of it. And in the next one, we will head inside of here and probably die. But we will do that in the next episode. Basket at you. Fade to black. Just joking. Hello.